Are we as loud as... What? Hello?
Hello? No, it sounds not as loud.
Why do we not sound very... Okay, there we go.
Maybe you got to find the right balance.
There we are.
Not white balance, the right balance.
There we are.
The right balance, there we are. My microphone always sounds like... I've been playing with it, but it always sounds like...
It's because of me.
Well, that there is from you hitting the microphone. I already got yelled at by Pat Porter. And Pat even yelled at Brandy Ford about
fidgety.
It. She ran over the street.
I can't help it. I'm fidgety.
Whatever. The show's working.
Just deal with it.
Every show is our first show. We always talk about tech problems right off the top because we can never get the studio warmed up here. We never know who's left at what. Yeah. The Viz's sunglasses have been in here 2 weeks. Her two bobby pins have been sitting on the counter for two weeks.
But it may not be her.
That's
it could
her.
Be any. There's other females who... work here. I don't.
Only the Viz wears these sunglasses.
Okay. Well, the bobby pins.
Only the Viz.
The bobby pins.
Listen, every
that could be. It wouldn't be me because my hair is too thin.
I know the Viz is on Saturday mornings, and I know every time I come in with Pat Porter, some of her stuff has been left here, including Ivy's paintings and everything else. So there's only one Ivy.
Okay.
And it even says Ivy in the paintings. Okay. So other than that, it could be Brandy Ford.
Yes.
I don't think it's Rob Repos. I don't think it's Paul Amir.
No.
Anyway, everybody's on notice. Take all your stuff out of the studio and leave it the way you found it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. You're so mean. Hitting the 12.
Oh, yeah.
I'm little K. This is Infamous J. Moore.
Thank you. Don't hit the microphone. It makes Pat Porter angry. You should have heard him yelling at me a couple episodes ago.
Well, because everything's all flimsy-dimsy.
Yeah, Todd Page evidently left the radio station after Pat yelled at him that... he was trying to fix stuff after 3 o'clock when he was supposed to be on the air. Even though...
boo.
I don't know. They just leave the wire hanging on the floor. Who cares? Take the microphone right out of the stand and who even cares about it?
I'm just going to stand here.
Let's just go home. Let's just go home.
I wonder if I could. Hold on. Let's see. No, it doesn't come out.
No, don't screw around because now it's on air and everyone's going to be upset that they know.
I touched it.
Yeah, the engineers and everything. God. Todd Page and everything. Dressed to Kill, the Kiss tribute band, will be up later on today.
Yeah.
Later on in this hour. After 8:30, I would say.
Dressed to Kiss.
Yeah, Dressed to Kiss, sorry.
Day.
Dressed to Kiss is the name of the Kiss tribute, and they're playing, February 24th, you said?
February 24th in Welland.
In Welland at the Legion, I believe.
Morningstar Road,
I think that's Morningstar Drive.
Yeah,
I'll look it up properly, but I think it's the Welland Legion. Kiss tribute. Star Child will be here, along with the Catman.
Catman.
Yeah. Which Catman
Isn't
was Peter Criss and Star Child was Paul Stanley.
Yeah.
So there you go with that. That's going to be up later on. We got some events to talk about and we got live music Friday and Saturday in the clubs that we will promote for you for absolutely free because that's what we do here at Hitting the 12. And little K, what else do we have on tap?
Events. Did you say that? Sorry, I got lost.
Yeah, events.
Local events.
I said it all. You wanted to talk about...
live music listing for Friday and Saturday.
Yeah, I said all that. You wanted to talk about Super Bowl, even though it was old news.
Okay, so it's Valentine's Day today.
Yes, everybody knows it's Valentine's
Day today. Family Day on Monday.
Okay, I forgot about Family Day.
Family. How can you forget? You just said you had the day off. Family Day on Monday.
I forgot to mention Family Day on air.
Okay. Family Day is on Monday. Lots of events going on.
Yeah, we'll
mention some of those.
Yes.
Super Bowl. Just happened.
Old news. It's not. It's Wednesday now. That
I don't know.
Sunday.
All I have to say is
you're just
that
for an
I wasn't.
To talk about
I
Super Bowl.
It was a close game. They went into overtime. It was the first overtime in the new rules that they have.
Yeah.
I wasn't really, really going for a team. Sean likes the 49ers.
Yeah.
So I thought. You know, at first, to make things interesting, I would go for the Chiefs.
Yeah.
And I could just keep razzing him all like, you know, oh, Taylor Swift is making the team all this money. And, you know, and then as we're watching, I see Paul Rudd and I was like, okay, that solidifies it. I'm going for the Chiefs. And who won?
The Chiefs.
The Chiefs. Thank you very much.
It's all because you went for them. Perfect.
Yeah, Super Bowl. Somebody saw, during Usher's performance, he was sweating like a pig. Somebody fell off the pole.
Please don't say that.
There were, you know, Alicia Keys in red and a red piano. All that jazz. It was pretty sweet. And just recently, some more current events. Beyonce has gone country.
Oh,
Did you hear about this?
No.
She just put out a new song called Texas Hold'em.
Texas Hold'em, yeah.
Yeah. That's she's original. Actually, she's from Texas.
All right.
So it kind of makes sense for her to do a country. I heard it. I heard it a lot on TikTok first. But then I heard it on the radio on the way here. And I was kind of bopping to it. I'm not a big country fan. Anyone who knows me, I'm not a big country fan. Beyonce, I liked it. Mm-hmm. It had a good base to it.
Okay.
It was good. Really good. So that's, you know, Amazon is having a lawsuit. Did you hear about that?
For what?
Well, because if you are an Amazon Prime user, Prime Video, you would have noticed earlier this week that they asked you for an extra $2.99, which after taxes came to like $3.25.
Yeah.
Or whatever. And it's so that you don't have ads run during your... And that's, like, I totally understand why people are gonna, like, sue them, because they have been advertising as... advertising free.
Well, the business motto is new now. I explained last time.
Don't advertise yourself.
Last time we had
a breach.
Rob Burke on, and I was talking about Rob moving to Netflix. That's exactly what's going to happen to Netflix. Yeah. When Rob moves to Netflix, they're going to be advertising, and you'll pay for another tier to get no advertising. And all of these streaming apps now are all combining or all joining forces so that you have to pay more, and they're going to change the business motto, and you are now paying, you know, when it gets into a $100 mark for all these apps, you're now paying the same as what cable was. So we have reinvented the wheel, and now we have gotten cable money that we're paying out for streaming apps. So, yeah, expect more of it. That's what I'm saying.
I'm trying to add it up in my head.
Sorry about the bad news.
Because I have Amazon.
Get rid of it. I got rid of my Spotify. I got rid of my YouTube Premium. Get rid of it. It's just a waste of money.
And I got Paramount through that and Hey You through that because, like, you know, reality TV, that's me.
Yeah, well, if you're paying for that, it's just a waste of money. You might as well take your money and throw it out on the road.
I'm just trying to add it up in my head.
You can watch anything on YouTube for free pretty well.
Not without advertisements.
No, so what?
That's what I'm saying. I'm not paying for prices.
No advertisements. I don't care. I'm not paying for this anymore. I'm taking a stand against it. And if you don't take a stand, as well as the other people that will not take a stand because of the sheep that, you know, drink the Kool-Aid, then you can pay for no advertising all day long. Okay. But you're going to pay a premium because that's what it's going to be. So, yeah, you're a sheep. Yeah. Drink the Kool-Aid.
Oh,
drink it.
I'm going to smell it first.
Yeah, well, you're smelling and you're bitching, but you're going to pay it. Or you're going to find some illegal streaming. Yeah.
I already did.
Yeah, exactly.
I was like, forget this. I want to binge a series right now. I don't want to keep stopping for advertisements.
Oh, well, yeah, I guess for stuff like that.
I would just watch it on regular TV.
I don't have the attention span to sit through like a full movie, really. Oh, well. A lot of times I fall asleep, so. Oh. I don't know. There's not a whole lot of Netflix I enjoy. Not at all.
You're going to find the right stuff.
The one I was watching yesterday was with Ashley was, it wasn't too bad, but there was a lot of holes in the story. But I think you're going to know what I'm talking about because you're a Netflix whore. the one where the guy goes on Plenty of Fish and meets his chick and then the chick ends up killing. What's the name of that one?
I didn't watch
Lover,
that
Stalker.
One.
Yeah, watch that one.
That's, Lover, Stalker, Killer. That's a new one.
That's a new one. I watched it last night. It had my interest as far as I want to see what's going on next, but there's a lot of holes in this story, a lot of bullshit.
Okay.
And I'm sick of Netflix, which is feeding me the bullshit, and now you want me to pay for it. I'm not paying for it, so thank you.
Okay. All right. Should we maybe get to some events?
Oh, yeah. So let's get to some events before the KISS guys get here. Dressed to KISS. We'll talk to them a little bit later on.
Should we play a song first?
I don't know. What time is it?
We got lots of time. Let's play a song first. A local song.
Seems pretty tight. All right, play something.
Yeah, I think we got time. I want to hear, I'm going to pick one. Eeny, meeny, miny. Stereo Stars.
Yeah.
No Words. We'll be right back. Stereo Sunrise.
Stereo Sunrise. I swear you said Stereo Stars, but...
Stereo Stars. No.
Yeah,
Stereo Sunrise.
Let's talk about some events, okay?
Okay,
hold on. I'm going to whip off two real quick, if you don't mind.
Two?
Yeah, because I got a short one here. Long weekend loaded Caesars and Charcuterie.
Charcuterie.
Yes, I always say it wrong. At the LTD Distillery, that's Friday. That's February, yeah, Friday, February 16th to the 19th. That's
which
a Monday.
Is Monday.
So all weekend long, Friday to Monday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. That's a long weekend loaded Caesars and Charcuterie, LTD Distillery, February 16th to the 19th. That's Friday to Monday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. And the Valentine's Day Comedy Show is... it's a comedy special Niagara, which sounds weird. It sounds like the people in Niagara are special. No, Valentine's Comedy Show special happening in Niagara. It's Friday, 8 o'clock at Taps. Join us for a hilarious night of laughter at Taps Brewhouse in Niagara Falls, Ontario. This Valentine's comedy special promises to be a night filled with jokes and nonstop laughter, hosted by Tipsy Theory, your one-stop website for all the best events, eats, drinks, and more in Niagara. That's tipsytheory.com. Start the night off with MC Adrian Toby, with amazing comics Lori Elliott, Ted Morris, and headliner Jean Paul. There you go. So that's happening at Taps Friday night, okay. Queen Street, Niagara Falls.
Can I go now?
Yeah.
Okay. Owls of Heartland. This Friday is a PA day. So this is a great PA day activity starting at 10 a.m., $2.50 per child. That is pretty cheap. You're going to go on out to Heartland Forest and create a screech owl nesting box. These boxes are vital to the long-term sustainability of the screech owl population. The boxes will be placed throughout Heartland Forest to encourage screech owls to call us home. That's pretty cute. They want you to purchase the purchase ticket is per child. Adults accompanying each child is free to attend. Children 6 and up can attend through our recommended age, though the recommended age is 8+ for the best experience. Tickets are priced per child in attendance. Adult accompanied is required. Rain or shine event. So get on to that. I am then going to go to another event because we have our guests are coming in here. So let's go to Saturday at 10 a.m. right until 4 p.m. The Exchange Open House. This is happening in Niagara Falls. It's at 5943 Sylvia Place in Niagara Falls. It's been and really anticipated. This opening is being held this Saturday. It's a multi-purpose event space that will serve as the epicenter of Niagara Falls arts and culture. All are welcome to the open house from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. and it's free. The drop-in style event will feature art installations, live music, activities, vendors, and more. The community will be able to explore the new arts and culture facility, including the market hall, artist and woodworking studios, and cafe, opening at a later date. The open house highlights that we want you to make sure that you get to explore the creative spaces at the Exchange, including artists and woodworking studios. Market vendors that are included are Niagara Samosa Factory, Shriners Creek Kettle and Popcorn, Fiesta Empanada, The Fungi Guy Gourmet Mushrooms, Moody's Bakery, Brie Ann Farms, Harvey's Honey, DeVries Fruit Farm. Of course, there's going to be live music and a DJ throughout the day. Niagara Falls In Focus Photography will have an exhibit. And there will be temporary and permanent installations on the interior and exterior by Adam Butler, Nicholas Crombatch, Dylan Douglas, and Jacob Headley. And there's going to be other participating artists, along with on-site activities and games, a collage party by Paper Bananas, screen painting by NAC, magicians Matt Anthony and Robert Chan, Again, free admission at the Niagara Falls History Museum and their new exhibition, My Story, My Tattoo. Free on-site parking is available on a first-come, first-served basis, as this is going to be busy. They want you to know that soon they are going to have a farmer's market, which will open at its new permanent home later this spring. Matei Cafe will open its second location at the Exchange in the next coming months. And there's a lot of exciting programs that will be announced, like NFX Nights, Paw Exchange, and On the Rocks. So there's going to be a lot going on. You want to make sure that you get to the Exchange Open House Saturday at 10 a.m.
Yes, and I got a quick couple here. Niagara Family Fun Day, that's happening this Saturday at 10 a.m.
Fun Day.
At Merton Lions Club. We'll post everything up on the Hitting the 12 events page. And this one, exclusive pairings dinner, romance in a glass, happens Saturday at 6:30 p.m. at Peller Estates. Join Chef Jason Parsons. We talk about him all the time. And his culinary team for the February exclusive pairing experience, romance, and the glass edition. Upon arrival, you'll be greeted with a glass of Peller Estates Signature Series Ice Crevet. You'll be seated on a commercial table and enjoy an exclusive five-course tasting menu with delicious wine pairings from our Peller Estates collection. Our chefs will introduce each course, and wine expert from a restaurant team will introduce each wine pairing. So that's happening at Peller Estates Saturday at 6:30. It's exclusive pairings, dinner, romance in a glass.
I have a part. I just swallowed a frog. All right. Niagara. That didn't really make sense. Swallowed a frog. Does that make sense? No.
Come on.
Okay.
Come on. Our guests are here.
Okay,
come on.
Okay, that's what I was about to say. Okay.
Step on the gas.
Oh, calm yourself. Niagara Fresh Family Fun Fest. That is a mouthful. This is Saturday at 10 a.m. in Fenwick. They're going to have between 50 and 70 vendors with free samples. Ooh. Food, crafts, homemade goods, and so much more. They'll have a wide selection of lunch options available with dine-in food court and even a bouncy castle for the kids to play on. The event will carry a $10 entry fee per vehicle, so please carpool to save parking spots and to save you money. This fee will cover parking, entry, bouncy castle access, free samples, and will also include a $10 coupon to use in store.
Yes, and going into Family Day, I got a couple here for Family Day, little K.
I have some too.
Yep.
I have one for Sunday.
Yeah, yes, yes.
Should I do that one first?
Sure, go ahead.
Because, you know, it's Sunday before Monday.
It's not really Family Day, but go ahead.
Yeah, so I should do this one first. So Sunday.
Should be disqualified.
There's free community skate with MPP Wayne Gates.
Oh, he's not going to skate on Monday?
No, he's going to do this on Sunday so that you can spend the rest of your time on Family Day with your family.
Wasn't Wayne Gates the guy that refused an interview when we were at the St. David's Carnival?
No, we thought he was going to, but he didn't.
No, he did. So let's refuse to talk about Wayne Gates.
No, we did a thing with him. You said, you asked the question.
Okay, go ahead. Sunday.
All right.
It's just weird that he has
Wayne Gates wants you to join him for his free community skate for the community here in Niagara Falls, Fort Erie, and Niagara-on-the-Lake. The skate is open to all members of the public with free hot chocolate and snacks. It will take place on Sunday, February 18th from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. at the Niagara Falls Gale Center, pad number 1. That's all I had to say.
All right.
Just been, you know, noble.
Family Day fun and games at Welland Main Arena. That's happening Monday at 10 a.m. Let me tell you what to expect. Join us at the Welland Main Arena for some fun games on Family Day. On the ice will be free skate and donation with perishable food item, free helmet, skate aid rentals, free hot dog or fries, and drink voucher for every child. Learn to skate area for beginners. Play area to try ringette. Off the ice, interactive virtual gaming like bowling, table tennis, darts, golf, and dancing. Kiosk gaming on PlayStation or Xbox. Can't get away from that. Large board lawn style games, Lego station, and face painting. That sounds like fun in Welland at the Main Arena, happening Monday at 10 a.m. And then we head over.
More on Monday.
We head over to St. Catherine's. Stop it. I'm on a roll here. I want to get this done.
I still have two as well.
All right. Well, you want to go back and forth. Okay, go ahead. Okay. Boring. Go ahead.
Okay. 2024 family day adventure in Pelham. This is happening on Monday at 11 a.m. at the Meridian Community Center in Pelham. You're going to celebrate from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. for some family fun activities at the Meridian Community Center on Monday, February 19th. Their residents can participate in free family events hosted at the Meridian Community Center. You already said that. Activities include drop-in family gym time, laser tag, family skates, and more. In addition, community sports organizations, service clubs, and not-for-profit organizations will be on site for the annual community expo. Non-perishable food donations will be accepted at the expo. Food donations will be accepted at the expo. For full event listings, visit www.pelham.ca/family day.
And family day at the park in St. Catharines, Monday at 10 a.m. Join us for free and ticketed events starting at 10 a.m. Activities include hands-on arts and crafts, classic cartoons and cereal, an interactive screening of Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory hosted by the Hub of the Hammers, the Drama Garden by Carousel Players, Niagara Sympathy Postcards from a Blue Planet, a musical adventure, No Excuses, No Limits by Ill Abilities, and so much more. The full schedule is at firstontariopac.ca, and also hit the 12 events, and that's 250 St. Paul Street, downtown in St. Catharines, the First Ontario Performing Arts Center, Monday at 10 a.m., the family day at the PAC.
And then we have another family day. It's a run of the rink event by the town of Grimsby at the Peach King Center. Free public skating in both pads, generously sponsored by Canadian Tire and the Zoy Was Team Remax. Fun for the whole family in our Tim Hortons sponsored Family Fun Zone. Face painting, balloon twisting, Club Rex, creative bug, and an appearance by a cartoon favorite, Blue Heeler Puppy. Joan Bones, the Niagara Ice Dogs mascot, for a skate from 1 to 2 p.m. And outdoors, enjoy fire pits, s'mores stations, taffy on snow, if there is snow, and live kids music. Weather depends on the outdoor rink will be open for free public skating as well. Did you have any others? Or is that all yours that you, like, rushed to rush?
Why, you got more?
No, I don't. Do you?
No, but I do know that... coming into studio, we got Star Child, we got Catman.
Yeah.
Dressed to Kiss is going to be here. They got a big show on the 24th in Welland. We'll talk more about that. I say we play some music and get the boys in here.
Absolutely.
And talk a little bit of Kiss here on 4680Q hitting the 12.
Well, I was made for loving you, baby.
I was made for loving you, baby, with you.
Yeah.
Here we go. I liked it.
Of course you like it. It's Kiss, and it's Valentine's Day, yeah. And what better word? There's got to be a play on words there. I don't know.
Yeah.
Something.
Dressed to Kiss.
Well, the boys from Dressed to Kiss are here. Are you going to give them the grand introduction?
Dressed to Kiss on Valentine's Day. Isn't that what everybody's doing tonight?
Okay.
Didn't you see that segue at all?
No. Sounds like a great Seinfeld joke or something, but...
Really? Yeah. That's all you had? Okay.
Yes.
Anyways, this incredible Niagara's Own Dressed to Kiss is performing February 24th at the Welland Legion. Please welcome Starchild and Catman.
How you doing?
Good.
How's everybody tonight?
Beautiful.
Good.
They sound like Kiss.
I won't go full Paul Stanley on you.
Well, we have to distinguish who's who, so you should go full Paul Stanley.
All right. How you doing, people?
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, Mike McCary would be so jealous of that.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
Mike's a good friend.
I know. I figured he was. I wanted to bring that up to see.
Mike's a good friend, and the roots of this band actually started with a conversation with him.
It did?
Really?
Oh, my God. And he's not Paul Stanley?
No, I actually reached out to him asking if he would be Paul Stanley.
You did?
I reached out to
him. Oh, my God. Can you imagine that?
When I thought about
it. What did he say to that? He must have been excited about it.
He was definitely excited, gave a lot of thought. As you know, he's a very busy.
Yeah.
Very busy.
Oh,
man.
He's got like five bands.
Like, everybody wants him.
Yeah.
And he considered it, and we talked. And then as time went on, I was considering portraying Gene Simmons. I decided I want to take a stab at the being Paul Stanley.
Nice.
So I talked to him about it, and with his blessing, we went ahead.
Nice.
And it's just funny. It's a small Kiss world.
Yeah, it is. But it's a legend band.
Absolutely.
It's a legacy band. It's a legend band, and it's a tribute. That's what you guys are doing, is a tribute band. How you feel about being Catman?
Oh, it's
And what's the decision behind you being Catman? Is it because you play drums, or did you look for...
So the origins of this band actually started about 25 years ago. Steve, myself, and our spaceman.
So 25 years ago, Mike McCarrion would have been 15? I don't know.
We were.
Right. Okay. Right.
We all started playing together in high school.
Nice.
And this is just something...
The classic high school band. The boys are still playing.
Right. We all did our things separately for a long time, and then Steve came to me asking me if I wanted to do this. And
so what other bands have you been in that have been local? Have you played local bands here, or no?
Just bands that played, you know, in front of 10, 20 people, that kind of thing, you know?
Yeah, at the bars, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Well, that's good, man. I mean, a good Kiss tribute is needed here in Niagara, I would feel.
Yeah. There's a bunch of Kiss tribute bands, but one from Niagara.
It's true. Yeah. Only one from Niagara.
We thought that would be really cool because a quick YouTube search will show you there are very, very many Kiss tribute bands out in the world. And I questioned myself if I was giving the world something else it needed more.
No, I think they do need it. But I think Kiss in Welland at the Legion is going to be something to watch.
Well, and because there are so many, how did you decide on Dressed to Kiss?
So Dressed to Kiss, Kiss with a long, varied history of 50 years. The concept of this band came from the things that come up in my mind when I think of Kiss: Marshall amps, Pearl drums, smoke, lights, high energy.
I remember the record label being like Casablanca.
Absolutely.
Or something.
Casablanca Records back in the 70s.
Yeah, yeah. The Destroyer album.
And it's a rock and roll party, like Paul says.
Yeah.
And that's what we wanted to throw. But the reason we didn't book ourselves or want to do smaller venues or bars is we want to put on a show. So when you come to see Dressed to Kiss, you're going to be seeing a show.
Yes.
It's not just going to be anything other than the most accurate representation that we could possibly give.
So when you say show, like, you guys are portraying the original Kiss. Is that why you went original Kiss as well?
Yeah, there's taste. Like, the members are portraying the original members.
Yeah.
They're definitely the most identifiable.
Yes.
Gene, Paul, Peter, Ace.
Yes.
And we're also doing some 80s tunes, so nothing's off limits as well. So we have that look, we have that show, that vibe of that 70s Kiss vibe going on.
So you might be doing Heaven's on Fire or something.
We will be doing Heaven's on Fire, absolutely.
So that's cool, the old school, the original Kiss in makeup, in costume.
What?
Doing even some of the newer Kiss, yes.
I had a question. Okay, so, you know, you guys played in high school and stuff, but was the costume a prerequisite to join the band? Or did you accumulate it after?
So, Steve himself has been putting this together for about 2 years. I've been in for about a year and a half building this. The costumes were something that we put together over these last 2 years. I know Steve and myself have performed dressed as somewhat Kiss in high school, but it was never like that. We just covered some Kiss songs and Zeppelin and stuff back in high school, right?
Yeah.
And but this was, we wanted to make the music the main part and make the performance part of it the biggest part of all of it, right? We want people to feel that when they come to see us, not only do they get a really good representation of Kiss, but they get to see a really good band rock them all night long. Right?
Yes, yes, exactly. That's why this is a party that's going to be happening well on the 24th.
How do you... Okay. On top of that question, how do you acquire these pieces to be in your costume? Oh, that, like that?
That's top secret information. Yeah. But I will divulge it just between the four of us in this room. Basically, there is a community. You can buy the stuff now. It's becoming a little more easier to get. There's some of it available. A little bit, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe to me, in my mind. But,
on eBay or something, yeah.
But we had our costumes custom created and built by people that do this on a regular basis. Okay. And I'm guessing all these tribute bands keep them very busy.
Yeah.
So
can you give a name out there?
Yeah, actually, like, my costume was designed by David McBrayer, who's out of Texas.
Oh, wow.
And another gentleman named Barry Carr made my boots. The boots are an animal all of their own. They're 6 inches. Yeah. They're very heavy. I got a call when I sent my order in because they'd never made a pair this big because I'm 6'4".
Yeah.
So, and size 14 boot. So these things are absolutely
monstrous.
Solid.
And oh, my God.
Because we want to, I insisted on, I want to do a Paul Stanley presentation, moving. Yeah. He's nimble and he's all over the place. I can't have my boot breaking.
Yeah.
So we had a small viral moment a little while back where my boot did break during a rehearsal.
You're kidding me.
And we threw it on TikTok, and it's done quite well for us.
The toe? Oh, wow. The toe?
Yeah, the whole
sole,
heel. The whole
sole,
thing.
The sole from
you must have been pissed.
It was the ground was hard and unforgiving. But those boots, just to be clear, weren't made by Barry Carr.
Oh, okay.
And that's why I reached out to my good friend who made me ones that won't do that.
Do you do each other's makeup or do you do your own?
Every member does their own makeup. I find when we talk to the ladies on this,
do you sit there like, yeah, I'm going to do yours?
No, yeah, the ladies want to know. Yeah,
we don't share lipstick. but yeah, we do share makeup sometimes. But
the white and the black, right?
It's like we're all learning this thing together. And it's really surreal to look down and put on my makeup and working on my star. And I look up and all of a sudden Gene Simmons is sitting in front of me because he's been deep in there, and it's a very actually quiet time when everybody's doing it. But that has become it's fun. It's just another part of it, and it's hard not to get in the mood for some Kiss when you're dressed like that.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, I would bet that that whole part of the process before show would really put you into your character and into the mood and into the groove.
Oh, 100%. And part of it, too, is you can see the makeup on Peter or Eric Singer or Eric Carr or any of the other people that wore it. And each one of them, their face looks different, so it's harder to do it. So you have to learn how to make your face look like that character.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. By learning how to cut lines with the makeup to make your jaw look thinner. And
now, how long is that process? When you first go and look at this and you say, okay, I'm going to make my paint look like this.
The process to learn it or the actual process?
Yeah, the process day to do it and learn it, I think, is kind of hand in hand. Yeah. Really.
It's basically jump in the deep end and go. The first time I did the Catman makeup, it took me about an hour and a half, and it looked okay.
Right.
Now I'm down to about 45 minutes, and it looks pretty good.
And now you know why women take so long getting ready.
Oh, absolutely. And I've had more conversations like that with females over the last little while about makeup and hair, and I'll ask female co-workers and friends, family. It's like, hey, any tips on making my hair more bouffant? I need it really big.
Yeah, you need a puffy.
These are not tips that Alex and I had. You know?
You got the teasing and the hairspray. Well, to paint the
star must take some work, too.
Yeah.
Because that's not a full like star. That comes out like halfway, right?
It's a...
Do you have like a cutout?
A stencil?
No, it's a...
Stencil.
People have tried that.
You know that word?
And we've tried different things, too. Yeah. But like, it's more of a perspective thing. You want, if for the star to look right front on,
yeah,
it actually looks morphed and stretched to the side.
Yeah.
So... The funniest thing, if you look at any of the band members' cell phone camera rolls right now, the pictures, you know, when you're really trying to get details down on something, just Paul's face, stars, shots, how'd it look like here, how'd it look like there.
Yeah.
And it's just like compare. Like Alex said, when we took on the mindset that we want to maybe present ourselves more than just throwing a star in my eye, but making it look more.
Yeah.
It became really something unique.
Wow.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah,
I have some more questions.
Go ahead.
So, the outfit, the costume, the makeup, that's one part, right? The music is another. The lights. Do you have a company that comes in and does the lights for you? How does that work? And how do you, do you give them direction as, like, this is the song we're playing, this is the lights they did at this concert, this is how I want it to look? Or, like, how did you base the lights and program them off of?
So, for starters, where we rehearse, we're fortunate enough to have a space where we actually have lights up where we rehearse. We stream live to TikTok quite often at DTK Canada.
Okay.
That's our handle on there. And we'll live stream jam. We'll put on concerts on the spur of the moment sometimes. Not in makeup, but that will be coming in the future.
Nice.
And, I'm sorry. I derailed myself. The lighting.
So with the lights, Steve doesn't do so much the technical stuff. He breaks it, but he doesn't do
it. Right, yes. Let's talk to the cat, man.
We've got a gentleman, Jim Winnie, that put us in touch with a guy named Jerry that's going to be doing our light setup for the first show.
Okay.
It's just going to be a basic setup because we're trying to portray that 70s stage show.
All right.
Right? Like, yeah, we could go out and get lasers and all that stuff, right?
But in the 70s,
you didn't have that, right? You had halogen lights and everybody was sweating under the lights.
Yeah.
So we're going to have a lot of color changing, strobes, stuff like that, moving headlights, stuff like that. So he's going to make a few scenes for the different songs. So like when Gene comes out and splits out the blood, it's going to be all green light so that the blood really glows. Well, so
that even happens in blood.
Yeah.
I was thinking in my head like the, you know, the Animal Eyes concert where it's just a guy on stage and stuff like that.
No, Jay.
I would love to have got Alex that cheetah print onesie that Aaron Carr wore on that.
Nice. Nice.
That was an iconic year for fashion for Kiss.
Yes.
You'd be so lucky to see that.
Yeah, and along with the lights, when Alex was saying about putting the band together over the last couple of years, the amps, the guitars, it's all authentic.
Oh,
The Paul Stanley model guitars, the Axe bass,
beautiful.
The Punisher bass, the Les Paul, Ace Frehley and Les Paul are like, you know, peanut butter and jam, they go right together.
Yeah.
And it's we wanted to get the real sound, so we tracked down the real Marshalls. That's hard to do now as a rock band.
Yeah.
I didn't realize how hard it would be to get a Marshall stack in 2023, and then I realized it's 2023.
Nobody does it anymore. Nobody does it anymore.
Most bands, wisely, when they're performing live, don't have to bring big amps. You can run direct. There's all technologies advanced.
But it wouldn't be Kiss concert without having those Marshalls there. It wouldn't be...
You're going to feel the air on your face.
Yes.
The people up front will feel the music.
I'm sold already.
Yeah,
I want to go to the concert. Yes.
February 24th at the Royal Canadian Legion in Welland.
Yeah.
That is 383 Morningstar Avenue. Again, Welland. It's going to be crazy. We're not done.
It's going to be a crazy night.
Yeah. And let's mention your socials quickly before we get back into some more questions.
So Dress to Kiss Canada on Facebook, on DTK Canada on Instagram and TikTok at DTK Canada. And... yeah, that's what we got going right now. And we're going to be live streaming a lot. We're very active on TikTok.
Yeah, so growing up.
Dress to Kiss Canada. There is another Dress to Kiss.
And we have tickets to give away to a listener.
Yeah.
So we're going to give more information on how we're going to give them away.
All right. What, on the pages?
We're going to say it tonight while we're doing the interview.
All right.
But we're not done the interview. I'm just taking a little hey, promote the show, promote their stuff.
Okay.
Why are you looking at me like that?
I like that. It's very
professional. I'm just listening.
Okay, so that's right. So we've gone through, you know, the costumes, the makeup, the lighting, the equipment. So now, the music. Let's get right down to the music. How did you first set up a playlist, and how flexible is that playlist?
So it's very flexible in the sense that if I had my way, I'd learn every song in the Kiss catalog.
Well, yeah, I'm that guy.
But as far as the show goes, as far as performing goes, much like the things that these bands like Kiss have to deal with, and it's a good problem, but people want to hear the hits. I Was Made for Loving You, as you were playing earlier, Detroit Rock City, Rock and Roll All Night, I Love It Loud, Lick It Up. It's all happening. We're doing all of that.
See, I told you.
Nice.
I told you.
Well, I wasn't sure, and here's what I wasn't sure about is
told you.
I thought it was going to be, because this is what I was thinking in my head. If it's the original Kiss, do you stop at when the band changes members?
Some bands do that, and I get that if they have a very specific vision, but I wanted to encompass everything.
Yeah, because they have some damn good songs that you'd be leaving out.
Absolutely. I want to hit on it all. Like, as a Kiss fan, this was my dream set list that I came up with. And the deep cuts are deep. We're doing things that Kiss hasn't done live. Because as a fan, I thought that would be interesting.
Yeah.
That is interesting, sure.
And so it's going to be, the songs you know and love.
Yeah.
Maybe even if you're not familiar with them, you check some new Kiss tunes out that you didn't get a chance to hear.
There's a lot.
That would be my kind of.
There's a lot of Kiss out there.
Incredible songwriters.
It's almost like
so many albums.
Yeah.
Absolutely. There's so many albums.
I'm not a huge, like, I don't know everything about Kiss, but I do find that there will be songs playing, and I'll be like, oh, who is this? And they'll be like, oh, it's Kiss, and I'm like, that's a Kiss song. What?
Yeah.
I think one of the things that's interesting with all the albums all the years, the production styles change. You know,
they sure do.
Things really change. Keeping up with them. They're, you know, you do what you got to do. And when we're presenting maybe some of the 80s songs or different music, we have that 70s sound. So that's the core of it. So whatever you hear us doing, it's going to have some real oomph to it.
Rock and Roll All Night, Detroit Rock City. Yeah.
You're rifling them off. Absolutely.
Yeah. No, but you're right with the eras change, because I remember some that got buried that I thought were decent, like God Gave Rock and Roll to You.
Absolutely.
You know,
incredible song.
I thought it was incredible too, and you never hear that anymore. Yeah.
Paul Stanley used to say it was the right song or the right album at the wrong time.
Yeah,
it is. By the wrong band, perhaps, right? Yeah, absolutely. And it's just doing a tribute to a band like Kiss, and specifically Kiss, the wealth of material is absolutely overwhelming.
Yeah, for sure.
So,
but I couldn't see the Kiss, like what you guys are going to portray on the 24th, doing God Gave Rock and Roll to You necessarily.
Well, that one, it'll be around, but
really?
I won't give anything away
as
part of the show. Uh-huh. But what you're going to see at the Welland Legion on the 24th will be two full sets of... We're going to go an hour each. So you're basically going to get two concerts with a break in the middle.
Excellent.
And both concerts are going to have a beginning, a middle, an end.
Yeah.
We're going to give you two Kiss concerts.
That's cool.
Okay.
That's cool.
And part of when, I know for myself, when we were putting this together and learning the music, we didn't necessarily sit down and learn the album versions. We scoured through live sets, live video.
Oh, yeah.
For myself, there's two guys that really played Catman for an extreme amount of time, and they played it differently. So I took parts from each of them to try and create
the best
version of the songs we could present as what people would see as Kiss.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And everything is choreographed, and we've staged all the songs.
I like that. Yeah. It sounds like all ground has been covered.
Definitely.
That's an interesting take on it, like to mix it all together.
Absolutely.
The best of the best.
Yeah.
Our lead guitar player who plays Ace, his name is Darren, and he's stellar guitar player and pretty well known around. And hearing him with his doing the Ace styles and then ripping through some of those 80s solos, and it's just fantastic.
It's
really exciting to hear.
Now, who does the Demon? Who does Gene Simmons?
That would be our friend Matt.
Okay.
And he is incredible. One of the major hurdles to doing a tribute like Kiss is there's four stars in the band. There's four guys.
Sure.
Not, you have to find four people that are willing to go deep, deep down this rabbit hole.
Yeah, and they're all very distinct characters.
Very.
You know, it's not just like another band that's up there and everybody looks the same. Everybody's got a distinct
character too, though.
Yeah. Absolutely. And it's a big investment of, yes, of time and money.
It is.
It is.
It's a very big investment. It's not just a guitar.
I never
and
found
whatever.
Six inch heels on sale. It never happened.
Me either.
Right.
But we were a trio for a while, and we were looking for a Gene. And through getting more equipment for our show, more lighting trusses and things, a friend of a friend, next thing we meet Matt, and he's it's almost too good to be true. We're thrilled to have him.
Amazing.
You know, the band, everybody's got good attitudes. It's a real positive vibe. Like, it's about having fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he's half our age, so he's well, that's fuel good. On the fire.
That's some energy. That's we all need.
That's
energy.
Good. Yeah.
I need energy.
Well, you must get right into it. So he bites the tongue. He does the guitar. He's got the axe. He's got the whole shebang going.
Absolutely.
You know,
he's got a wall of ampegs.
Are we
going to
see
him.
The torch, the blowtorch inside the Welland Legion?
You're going to see what we can legally do while right, complying with all bylaws.
Oh, yes. Goodness. That's incredible. Again, February 24th, Royal Canadian Legion. 383 Morning Star Avenue. Make sure you get your tickets, but we have two tickets to give away.
Yeah. Where can you get the tickets for people that want to buy them?
Yeah, the tickets are available at eventbrite.ca.
Okay.
They're on sale now. If you're a little more old school and you would like to get an actual physical ticket, which after we went online, people are like, I want a real ticket. We printed up what were some pretty cool tickets.
Well,
the
tickets look damn cool. Yeah. We got to take a shot
I have
of
them
that.
In my hand.
Yeah.
We wanted to, if you're going to be kind enough to support us and buy a ticket to come up to our show, we wanted to have a little keepsake. So we're not going to tear it up or anything at the door. You get to keep that.
And, oh, cool.
As a memory.
It almost feels like a sticker and I want to put it somewhere.
Oh, and absolutely. Those tickets that are so cool are available at the bar in the Legion.
Okay.
Oh, nice. Beautiful.
So you can get them in your hand at the Legion.
And Central Music in Welland. Sorry.
Okay, Central Music in Welland. And then also go to Eventbrite. What you decide on how we're going to give them away.
I don't know.
After you stop coughing.
I got a real bug in my throat here. It's so dry in this studio.
Or as I said earlier, a frog.
I don't know. We can do a call in. What were you guys saying earlier? The best kiss story?
Yes. You actually, there we go. So,
best kiss story. I say we post it up on our Hit the 12 page.
Yeah.
The person with the best kiss story, and we'll leave the tickets right here at the station and they can pick them up.
Yeah.
There you go.
Well, they can pick them up. Like, I don't want to leave them with the riffraff here during the week.
Okay. Well, I hope that the riffraff never heard you say that on air, but whatever.
We allow riffraff to come to the show as long as they pay.
Of course. Of course. It's dressed to kill, baby. Okay.
So your best kiss story. It doesn't have to be at a concert or anything. It's just your best kiss story.
Well, people may lie about it. I want to see photographic proof that you're at the concert. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, it doesn't have to be you at a concert. It could just be a story about Kiss.
All right. Best kiss story wins. It'll be on the Hit the 12
maybe
page.
Somebody made you a life-size Lego thing.
February 24th, the boys from Dressed to Kill will be at the Welland Legion. Nobody knows what you're talking about. We'll have it posted up.
About.
Yeah. We'll have it posted up and you can win the tickets to that. DM little K for the tickets.
No, we're going
to. She'll drop them off to you.
You're such a dick. Okay. Anyways, again, let's hit those links to your profiles.
At DTK Canada. Check us out on TikTok for sure.
Yeah.
It's at DTK on Canada.
I saw some of those
impromptu shows.
Yeah. If you scroll through, you're going to see, you'll hear some tunes. You'll hear a lot of deep cuts on
You'll get Dressed to Kill non makeup and looking forward to Dressed to Kill makeup.
Dressed to Kiss.
Why do I keep saying it wrong?
Because
Dressed
you're
to Kiss.
It's our play on words.
I know. Dressed to Kiss for Valentine's Day.
Of course, Dressed to Kill is in my head because of the kiss. Yeah.
And if you're out there and you forgot to get your special someone something on this Valentine's.
Oh, that would be perfect.
Dressed to Kiss tickets are the perfect gift.
Yes, absolutely perfect. Day. Kiss and make up tour. That would be great too. Yeah.
So you're dressed to kiss.
Yeah, we get it now. I said it wrong. Dressed to kiss.
Okay. Just making sure you get it right finally.
Yeah. Get your tickets.
Yeah.
Get your tickets. They're at the door at the Legion. They're at the Legion. They're at Central Music. They're on the socials.
Yeah.
Dressed to Kiss DDK, baby.
We should play some more Kiss.
Do it.
Which should we play? Rock and Roll All Night, Cold Gin, Hotter Than Hell, or Deuce?
Oh.
That's a wonderful selection. We're not going to do Rock and Roll Night because everybody knows that one. Okay. Let's go Hotter Than Hell. Let's get this place.
Hotter than hell.
Oh, wow.
All right.
All right. We'll be back with the live music Friday and Saturday in the clubs. Heard that one in a while.
I like it.
Hotter
I
than
like
hell.
It.
I really wanted to hear Cold Gin, but
yeah.
Shout outs to Steven and Alex, the boys from Jurassic Kiss. Thanks for stopping.
You got
in.
It right this time.
I really did. And big show happening February 24th, Morningstar.
383 Morningstar Ave.
Avenue.
Royal
yes.
Canadian Legion in Welland, Ontario.
Yes.
Doors open at 7:30 p.m. We have two tickets to give away.
All right.
You tell them the rules.
The rules.
Well, it's not really that.
Did we establish rules?
The rule is that, oh, I guess not.
The best Kiss story.
The way, yes, the best. The way to win them is to give us your best Kiss story.
Yes.
Kiss story.
Yes. Now, this is not eligible for anybody that works at 1220 CHSC. Thank you.
CHSC?
Or whatever it's called. What's it called?
1220 AM?
Yeah.
I don't know. Ridiculous.
Well, I'm just saying that because I don't want those headbangers okay. coming in for free tickets. Okay. You know?
All right. Well, it's the end of the show.
Yes, and you know what that means. This is where we tell you about live music happening Friday and Saturday in the clubs. I will start with the 16th of February.
Which
that's
is Friday.
This Friday. Peninsula Soundscapes, which we talked about them on the last episode of Hitting the 12. Check it out in the archives of 4680Q. Peninsula Soundscapes will be at the Jordan House on Friday. Black Hat will be at Putty's. Pub Daddy at Maple Leaf Tavern. The Bash at Parker's Pub. Dizzy Rex at Cat's Caboose.
Darren Hancock at Big Texas. Maple Jam will be at Golden Brothers. Cottage Brew at Chip and Charlie's. Rhythm and Hounds at Rombies. And Patsy and the Muscle will be at Irish Hub in Little K. Is that a first for Dizzy Rex at Catskaboose?
Why you gotta do that?
I was trying to get right to the line for you. You didn't have to answer. Yeah, you just screwed everything up. Thank you.
No, I'm not, because I actually wanted to mention something. Maple Jam is not playing at Golden Brothers tomorrow night. It is JDM Band. Oh, for quite...
I'm done.
Maple Jam is not playing at Golden Brothers. It's JDM Band. And Peninsula Scale and Scapes also play on the 17th at Peloton.
Well, thank you for updating my info sheet.
Okay.
Jerk.
Here it comes.
I'm gonna ruin it. I'm gonna ruin it for you.
Hear it. Dun 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 dun. All right. We have New Rising Sun at the Irish Harp. Jammer at Lucky Penny. This is Saturday the 17th, in case I forgot to say that. The Trip is at Dive Pub. Maple Jam is at Lefty's. Mudmen at the Roselawn Theater. Rock of 80s at Manhattan's. Stuck in the 90s at the Angel Inn. The Spins at Ollie's. Cottage Brew at Putty's. Black Sheep at Golden Brothers. Hard Rock Hooligans at Chip and Charlie's. Big Shiny Tunes at Rombies. And Audio Works at Cat's Caboose.
Yeah, there you go. That's what's happening Friday and Saturday as far as live music goes in the clubs. And shout out to Pat Romano as well, who joined me last Saturday. He'll be playing with the Trip at the Dive Pub, as you mentioned, Little K. And him and Pat Porter got into it again on Saturday. Pat Porter does not like Pat
then
Romano.
Why do you keep getting him in on that show and not bringing him in on our show?
We will bring Pat Romano on a Wednesday night show.
You know?
Yeah.
Someone who appreciates that shenanigans.
All right.
So we only got to one. We had a really good show. We only played one local music because we played two Kiss songs.
Yeah.
But we played Stereo Stars, No Words.
It wasn't Stereo Stars. See, I told you earlier.
Did I just say Stereo? Yes. Oh my gosh. I even know.
Yes. It. So don't get mad at me for Dressed to Kiss. You've been saying it wrong. It hasn't been Stereo Stars played all night here on 4680. And we didn't play Kiss Cold Gin, so you're proposing that we play local music and get me a copyright strike. What a joke.
Anyway.
I think that's it, Little K. Yes. That's it for me.
Get
I'm in for
your
Mr.
Tickets.
Moore. Yeah, get your tickets. Go ahead.
Tell us your best Kiss story for some tickets to Dress to Kiss on February 24th.
Yeah.
Make sure you check out our group page for all the information on the events that we mentioned tonight.
Yes, yes.
As well as all the events that other people share. And we invite you to share.
Yes. And
share.
Go neopro.ca for April 13th.
Tarek,
first title defense for the Grand Independent Championship, and a ton of matches to be announced at goneopro.ca. I'm Infamous Jay Moore. What? Damn it. I'm trying to leave.
Okay, sorry. I'll shut up. Do it again.
No, go ahead.
I can't remember what I was going to say now.
I'm Infamous Jay Moore.
I'm Little K. Kendra.
And we are hitting the 12.